Okay, yo, I'm doing the Flying Scotsman on part of like a tutorial, I think. I'm doing this like what is supposed to be an iconic journey from Doncaster. I'm not sure where it's going to. Find out in a second. If it's got the name, I don't know. I think the Flying Scotsman's the 100th anniversary is like last year, 1923 to 2024. Okay. Like I've said previously, I don't know much about these locomotives, trains in general, anything like that. What I do know is it's a 612 locomotive, three-cylinder. And it's 612 because of the configuration, but I don't know the configuration of what. Okay. So. Pretty cool. I don't think I've ever been to Doncaster Station, so I couldn't tell you what it looks like or not. It's just near me, actually, Doncaster. It's not too. It's about an hour's drive. Really. Okay, got the fireman on board. So let's climb aboard. It would be nice if our fireman actually released the cylinder cocks for us, but I don't think that's going to happen. I don't actually know how long it's been sat here for. Get those doors done. Where is the cylinder cocks? Are they open or closed now? I think they're closed now, actually. Yeah, let's leave them open then. Okay. Some gamer skull was unlocked there. I don't know what it was. Something here that can be checked, but I don't know what it is exactly. I think it's just to double check that the glass drain fills up nicely. And it will both fill up equally as well. I don't have any clue what that does, so maybe I shouldn't fiddle about with this. Okay, that's strange. No idea. If you're unsure about anything like this, you might just press as many different buttons as possible. If nothing explodes, you've done something right. That's a philosophy. Obviously, there's been some upgrades to this locomotive. I think it was in Australia at one point in time, and then the National Railway Museum doing a huge marketing campaign and managed to buy it back. Which is pretty cool. I don't like being here. You have to sort of jump down, don't you? Okay. The brakes weren't released, that's why. leave that small ejector open. Listen here. Now that's the coal door. Okay, hopefully those passengers have loaded now, so we'll be able to get going in a second. Whistle somewhere here. Let's get a reverser forward. We'll lock those doors. And that regulator to 25% then. Close those cylinder cocks in this gate pretty early. Okay, gaining some speed, I'm going to knock that, this rig reverser down to 60 at the moment. Speed limit, but what I don't know is I don't know if you put forward a foot forwards just while we get speed up. Thank you. maintain 70. There. Mm-hmm. Are we stopping? Or... Oh, presumably we're stopping. Say, stopping. us down that way. Hello. Don't get long on these battery packs now. 48 miles. Come on, Marty. We need to get to 88 miles an hour. Go back and save the clock tower.
Or whatever it is they do.
I don't understand that. I'm putting the forwarder down, accelerating at a greater speed. So what was if I put it down to 30? Or close the regulator a little bit. Once when I went to Newark, 3 or 4 years ago, the entire place melted the manure. Shit, basically. The whole place melted shit. And it must have been when they were doing the fields and what have you around Newark. And everybody decided to do it all at the same time. I don't know what it was, but oh my god. I don't mind the smell of manure, actually. Like, so some types of like that sort of stuff that doesn't smell very nice, like dog shit, obviously it doesn't smell nice, you recognise that anyway. Cow manure doesn't sound, smell too bad, I don't think. I would say I like it. No, I won't. I'll be honest. I'd order it on eBay, I think. If it wasn't obscene. I think it's time to blow the whistle. Drop 3 miles an hour now. I just can't eke out that extra bit at all. Regulator's fully open. I've dropped the forwarder down to 43% now just to see if that makes a difference. I'll be flying through Newark in a second, but I don't know what speed I need to be dropping down. I presume this whole stretch is 100 miles an hour. I'm really not sure what else I can do on this, to be fair. Don't want to put coal in the boiler, do you? Grantham was east of Newark, not south. Maybe we're headed east. Doncaster, Newark. No, because I'm sure Newark's southeast. Oh, so maybe southeast then. Then somebody went up to live in Grantham. It's a bit strange actually, like his girlfriend was in Grantham. He was in Surrey. And then he made the move to Grantham, but that's a hell of a long distance relationship. That's all I know about Grantham, that's it. Banton, like, oh god, I used to crash it in Banton as well. Jesus, like, there'd be days I turn up and I think, oh, today's the day, I mean, I've slept well, peak fitness, this will be the day, and then he just walks all over me. Made it look like an absolute breeze every time as well. Oh, 99 miles an hour. Are we going to do it? Are we going to do it? Oh, God. Eking that extra 1 mile an hour. Just can't do it. I need to dump ballast. I'm afraid. I'm going to have to get rid of the fireman. It's too much weight. That'll save us 70 kilos. Actually, probably more like 80. He's a tough bug, isn't he? Go on, get out. Let's go. Out you go. What's the armrest for? It's making us as comfortable as possible. This is making him feel comfortable. Just touch your leg there. Like a virgin train. Yeah. Just to clarify, his window's open, isn't it? Listen, I'll leave the door open for you, mate. If you ever feel like it's got too much for you. 96 miles an hour. Bugger. Oh, what's that? What's that? What's that? What is that? idea what that is. Whether or not I should have been fiddling around with it, find out. Right. Put the forward back down to 67. I'm gonna gain a little bit. I don't think that makes any sense in my mind. I think it's all to do with the incline. I'm just going to have to wait till the downhill. Not quite cinematic as I was expecting it to be. It's like a drone shot, this, isn't it? We're on the way to Granville. If you're going to Granville, to wear flowers in your hair. Be sure to wear a nose plug. No, that's Newark. Come on, get up to, you're going down now. Eight miles an hour. Let's get rid of Alice. We need to dump the coal. We need to get the coal into there and then dump the rest. Dump the carriages. That'll go us up to 100 miles an hour. Really noisy. God, this must have felt absolutely epic in 1924, was it, when they did this run? I know there was trains in operation maybe from 1923. But this must have felt wow going on this bad boy. I think he had an upgrade, I don't quite know how it worked, but it was an A1. And then later upgraded to an A3, I don't think that is an upgrade or what. Oh my god, it is loud!
as either again.
Peace and quiet. I actually heard somebody hit a tennis ball there. It's crazy. Crazy level of sound detail. I'm really surprised at that. Quite loud. Right, reach the speed. How? Get some coal to the fire. Come on, do your thing. I can't do it. Come on. Lazy bones. You've got your own stick here. We're going slow, not faster. Bloody hell. Reverser down to 45. Let's see what difference that makes. Okay, so we're decreasing speed. Reverser all the way forwards. Regulator to 65. Bloody counterproductive. or something. Oh my god. Yes. Putting the forwarder, or the reverser, to reverse, or less forward, whatever that means. Rolling. He's going up in speed. He's not bothered. Very stoic in the R5. Miles an hour. Get in. Come on, you can do it. Anyone can do it. It's a Flying Scotsman. So named as did the London Edinburgh route. 6 miles an hour. Celebratory music there. LNER 729. No, I just made that up. It sounded like something, didn't it? I'm sorry for trying to chuck you out. offloading ballast. I really, in retrospect, it wasn't necessary. We managed to hit that target speed. And I'm sorry. Let me close your window, get you comfortable again. Don't touch that stick though, that's my stick. Quite strange actually, because this thing here from there to there is just effectively a specialised carriage, isn't it really? Even though it's the same colour and whatnot, the engine is really like there to there. Water's stored in here or something. Yeah, the water's stored there. So I don't know where the pipe is to get the water to the engine. The most you want to drop the regulator down to is about 25%. Wouldn't you agree, Mr. Fireman? And that's because, from my limited understanding, it's the steam that transfers all the lubricants around the moving parts. So you always want steam running through the system. I haven't played a whistle in ages, have I? This is the end of the speed test track anyway. It's not a station. Peterborough. Ah. That as a DLC, so I don't know if I'm using, I must be, I don't know. Or maybe it's something else. So we're stopping at platform 2.
going on here? Why are we stopping? I've not clicked anything. Fiddling around with my controls, mate, when I was looking at the map. Something dodgy happened then. Still got 3 miles to go. Station just as I was looking earlier. Must have been. I don't know, I call them Virgin trains. I don't know who runs them. Well, what they're called. Late to start speeding up now, isn't it? Okay, we're just a mile out. Absolutely perfect stop. Damn it. What's your next one? Back to the main menu, I think. Right, so that's the inaugural run of the Flying Scotsman doing its like iconic trip, or maybe its maiden trip. I don't know. When I say inaugural run, my inaugural run of the Flying Scotsman.